Hello guys, can you hear me well? So welcome to another class of TESOL. Today we are going to be talking about types of errors and their roles in TESOL. So basically we are going to be talking about errors, right? Before we start talking about errors, guys, I would like you to answer some questions that I prepared for you. Now it is question answer time. Guys, what kind of mistakes did you do when learning English? Okay, thank you for your answers. The next question is, did your teacher put a strong emphasis on correcting mistakes, or did they make you feel it was acceptable? Thank you guys for your answers. Then lastly, how did your teachers correct your mistakes? Maybe you remember any events or occasions or situations. Thank you for your answers. So, I'm going to present you key concepts of the lesson. These are the concepts that we are going to talk about, and we are going to discuss, and we are going to learn. Before we start our lesson, guys, can you find mistakes in each of these sentences? Yeah, let's do it quickly. We can do it together. So let's start from the first one. I have a good news for you. Is it correct? Do you see any problem? Yeah, I see. Yeah, guys, you are absolutely right. We don't say we have a good news for you. We say we have good news for you without any article, right? So the next sentence is, he has not yet gone to the bed. Yeah, guys, you are right. The correct sentence is, he has not gone to the bed yet. Guys, now I'm going to divide you into pairs. You have here 9 suggestions, and I would like you to discuss them and come up with your answers, whether you accept it or deny it, and don't forget to provide reasons why. Okay? So now I'm going to break into sessions. So we are going to be back after 7 minutes, or even 5. Thank you guys for all your answers. Now, we are finally good to move to the lesson. I'm going to introduce you a common word, mistake. But mistakes happen everywhere, okay? And it also happens in language learning. So there are 2 types of mistakes, error and slip. Errors are when students attempt to say something that is too difficult for them or over their level of language processing. Okay, basically this is error happens because of the lack of knowledge. So on the other hand, slips are what happens because of excessive tiredness, worrying, fleeting emotions or circumstance. So basically, errors happen because of lack of knowledge, and slips happen because of circumstance. It doesn't mean that students don't know the rules, okay? Now guys, I'm going to provide you reasons for errors. So there are 6 of them. Let's start from the first one. Interference. What is interference? Influence from the student's first language on the second language. This is known as interference or transfer. Students use their own language sound patterns, lexes or grammatical structures in English. Okay. The next one is developmental error. Students are figuring out and putting language into order, but they have not yet completed it. So this is what is known as a developmental error. The following is overgeneralization. These are mistakes in students' use of rule for one item of language in the wrong way to another item. So with development, these mistakes vanish. As an example, we can provide a verb go, and the past form of it is went, but students probably may say goat. Okay, the next reason is false friends. The term false friends refer to words that appear similar at first glance but have different meanings. For example, magazine. We all know what magazine means in Russian, right? This is the place where we go to do shoppings. But magazine in English means another thing. It's journal that we read. Okay? The next reason is interlanguage. Interlanguage is the learner's current version of the language they are learning. Interlanguage changes all the time, but can become fossilized language when the learner do not have the opportunity to improve. For example, a learner who has lived in English-speaking environment for many years but not attended classes or studied for some time has problems with reported speech and forming tag questions. His interlanguage has become fossilized. What does fossilized mean? So the next reason is fossilization, which is refers to the process in which incorrect language becomes a habit and cannot be easily corrected. For example, many advanced level learners who have Spanish as a first language do not distinguish between he and she. Guys, we are familiar with the reasons. Now it's time for the exercise number one. Read the task. You have 6 items in the box, and you have descriptions. So can you guys match them? For this task, I'm going to give you 7 minutes. We're back in 7 minutes. Now the next task is going to be about learning mistakes and types of mistakes. You have 6 questions, and you have to match them with student errors. So for this task, I'm going to give you 5 minutes, since it is not so long. Okay, we're back in 5 minutes. It was a good discussion, guys. The following task is about type of error. So here you have 5 teacher comments and 3 types of error. Can you guys say what kind of what type of error goes to the teacher comments? Yeah, we can do it together, actually. Okay, guys, another task for you is right here. Look at these examples of student errors, decide what the error is and each sentence, and discuss why you think the error is being made. You should use the terms in the box. Guys, we are almost done. Yeah, I hope it was useful for you, and I hope that you now are familiar with the 6 reasons that I introduced you in this lesson. So, as a final part of the lesson, let's play a quick game.